Hey, what's going on, friends and family? Welcome back to another episode of BK of Reviews, and today, man, I am so excited to finally bring this pair to you. But before we get started with anything, I definitely want to encourage everyone to hit that thumbs up button. It goes a long way. And also, if you're new to the channel, and I pray that you isn't, please subscribe. It's the best way of staying up to date with the most recent content, and you can also follow me on these social media platforms. With all that being said, with no further ado, let's get into the review. Well, as you can see, I have two pairs of sneakers here. This was something that I definitely needed to double up on. So let's check it out. Voila. As you can see, had to double up on this pair of Yeezys. The box pretty much says it all. And you already know, no review will be complete without for the receipt police, as well as the second receipt. So, let's get into it. Today, we're doing a review on a pair of Yeezy Boost 350 V2 with an actual color scheme of cream white, cream white, cream white, and a style code of CP9366. I'm actually going to move one of these boxes out of the way. As you can see, it's your standard 350 box. You have the 350 on the top, as well as the Boost on the side, your size label here. You have one side that is blank, and you also have the brand in here on the back. It is the slide out box as normal. As you can see, has that beige type tissue paper in here. It does come with two of them. Man, I have to say, originally, I was on the fence about the sneaker, mainly because I thought it was an all-white Yeezy Boost. But once you actually get them in hand, you can actually see that the sneaker isn't all-white. It's more of a cream color, that off-white silhouette. It does have some hints of white in it. We will definitely go into that. But as you can see, it has that all Primeknit upper. Let's get a little closer here. There you go. The entire sneaker has that Primeknit upper, which is very nice. You have the off-white rope laces. There you go. It does actually have the strip that goes across here, but it is kind of hard to see. We do have a UV light, so we definitely will show you the actual strip. I'm pretty sure it still says 350 supply on here, but for some reason you really can't see it. Maybe with the UV light you'll be able to see it. It does have the pull strap here in the back. The breads, I really wasn't a fan of the pull strap, but for some reason this pair is actually growing on me with the actual pull strap. You do have that standard translucent outsole here, more of a milky type color. As we go to the toe box here, this is where you can actually see the white threading that goes up the entire tongue, which is actually white. I know for some reason it may seem like everything here is white, but the stitching on the actual tongue is more white than the actual shoe. It goes up the entire tongue and stops right here. As we go to the lateral side, you can see it does come with your standard, hang tag, PRC, HK, UK, and F. On the medial side, you can see the Primeknit a lot better here. There you go. As well as the translucent outsole. As we go to the back of the heel, like I said, it does have that little pull strap here, as well as the heavy stitching on the back that is also white. And what I'm noticing here, you do have it's more of a darkish type yellow on this area of the actual midsole compared to the rest of it. As we go to the actual insole of the sneaker, it comes with your standard tissue paper, as well as, I guess you will call this a sticker. There you go, right here. Want that to focus. As you can see, US size 10. Let me take the insole out so you can actually see the insole. Here's your standard insole. That white, off-white insole with the Adidas brand in here in black. As we flip it, as you can see, it is flat here with your Adidas branding right there. And it also has, I'm not sure, there you go right there, some numbering as well as sizing. I'm not really sure what the YH stands for, but as you can see, it says 8.5 to 9.5. And let's go to the actual inside of the sneaker. You can see it has the little holes here where you can actually see the boost. And one thing I noticed earlier when I checked them out, it feels like the inside here kind of feels like suede. I'm not sure if the camera's picking it up, but right up here, these little areas where the actual laces go through, feels like suede, very soft. It does have the extra padding here on the back ankle area, as you can see, as well as the reflective Adidas three stripes. Want that to focus. There you go. As we go to the outsole, it's just standard outsole. Has that off-white, off-milk type color with your Boost branding here at the heel. And here's your actual Boost. And it does have more Boost that is actually exposed with Adidas branding right here at the forefront of the sneakers. This is definitely a nice sneaker. To be honest with you, like I said earlier, I was on the fence about the sneaker, but once I actually seen them in hand, this was something that I think will be nice for the summertime. I did purchase a UV light. Unfortunately, I didn't have one, so I purchased this from Amazon. As you can see, here's the actual box label. So we'll show you the little UV test that you can do. I've seen other YouTubers do a UV test on it. It's pretty cool, to be honest with you. Actually, let me turn these lights down here so you can see it a little bit better. There you go. So, as you can see with the UV light, you can actually, hold on, let me turn the second light off. So right now we just have the overhead light on. As you can see, it's a lot dimmer. And with the UV light, you can actually see the branding on it. There you go. You do have that skeleton type silhouette of it. As you can see, the white stitching on it, on the toe box area. As we turn it over to the lateral side, you can see the stripes. Kind of reminds me of the belugas. And the actual back stripe, or actual stitching on the back as well, in white. There you go. You see it all on the inside of it now. Originally, I thought the actual sole glow, but it doesn't. But you can see the boost. Might be a little hard. There you go. Do it this way so you can actually see it. And I can spin it around for you. It's pretty cool. I think the first time I actually seen this done was on the zebras. Pretty cool. But that's your UV test. I guess, you know, if you want to do that to verify that your pair is real, or if you just want to do a UV test, it's pretty much up to you. Definitely want to thank everyone for tuning in to another episode of BKL Reviews. If you enjoyed this video and you enjoyed the content, please hit that thumbs up button. It goes a long way. Also, if you're new to the channel, definitely hit that notification button. It's the best way of staying up to date with the most recent content. We post videos every Sunday at 12 noon. And you can also follow me on these social media platforms. With all that being said, with no further ado, I definitely want to thank everyone once again for tuning in to another episode of BKL Reviews.